it was really interesting to see a development response, a physical building that is positively impacting people's lives in a whole category that the Urban Land Institute and our development world is more and more focused on. And a lot of people moving into this cohort every single day, and those that can respond, just like Abe's have, would do very well, not only for their economics, but also for the community.
Abe's Garden is a center of excellence for developing and exploring and disseminating the best practices for the care of people with Alzheimer's disease. And so much of the research we did and places we visited were all about limiting what residents could do. And so the design of Abe's really centered around creating an environment both inside and outside where the residents could have the sense of freedom they have in their homes. So instead of moving into a facility where all the rooms are the same and all the living areas are the same, each area was completely different based on those ideas of how do you create an environment that'll support people interested in being able to move and have dance classes and movement classes. Or one household, there's a art room with a concrete floor where they can get messy. You know, like we don't want them to be so insulated from life that their lives are meaningless. Our idea was let's just throw out all the rules and try to create a wonderful environment for people to be in. And what it's turned out to be is a place where families want to stay longer. And so it really becomes a supportive community that's really exciting as an architect to have that effect.